think you respect your guest. Allah also loved and also had to give it, also loved this kind of incident. That's why Allah is going to send an ayat, reveal an ayat, that will be more answer also. He treated everyone, including his companion, with dignity and respect. The leadership of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was most comprehensive and dynamic. He was the model of virtue, the good character, and spirituality. He was a noble and compassionate teacher, a guide, and a reformer. He's a social reformer. That's why Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told, I was sent by God to teach you the good characters. So for 1400 years before, how the Arabic people act like this. How they act. They have no way to speak. They know how to speak. They didn't know how to speak. They didn't know how to act. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi told me, Allah sent him to this world, you come in the Makkah Akhlaq, to teach them good characters. Then he sent the Wahi. Then he sent the Quran. As a teacher, he ordered to convey his message in its own verse and entrusted them to his followers. As a statesman, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Arabian Peninsula is a great state whose capital was Medina. This is an important point. Why Allah Jalla Shanuhu sent Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Mecca? Because that people are worse than other countries. The people are worse than, they didn't know how to speak, the way of speak, how to act. If the child, if the female child born, they will put in the grave. Always in the night, the drinking, also gambling. They spend their life like this. So that's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Allah Jalla Shanuhu chose him in the as a prophet and as a good light to show that way from the darkness. He always emphasized with peace and harmonious relations instead of fight. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never introduced the war to anybody. According to the Islamic story, the people, the Jewish, the Quraishi Kuffars, they want to fight with Muslims. So Muslims want to stop the fighting. They never choose the fighting. They offered a visit to the people of Medina, unified Jews, Christians, and Muslims. He is a great role model. He helped to the, even give the chance to Jewish people also. He helped to the Christian people also. They want to pray in the Masjid Nabawi. No problem. You can pray in the Masjid Nabawi also. But on condition, no statue. Without statue, you can pray in the Masjid Nabawi. In the Masjid Nabawi. So the Masjid Nabawi is like a, and also the hospital. They use as a hospital. They use as a university. They use as a playground. Sometimes they also play games also. He broke the tribal system. It's an important one. He brutally taken out the tribal system after the conquest of Mecca and set the stage of new era of unified Arabia. He gave the chance of Bilal to make the Adhan, give the Adhan. So the Quraishi Kufas, they criticized Prophet Muhammad. You don't know people to give the adhan into Islam. You don't know guy. Prophet told, I want to curse the tribal. I want to destroy. I want to demolish. I want to destroy to the tribal system from the root and be taken out. He managed to put in place sound institutions supported by sound policies and used great wisdom in choosing the man to whom delegate classes. He commanded the troops in the battlefield and won resounding victories. But his great political vision led his followers to establish an empire larger than the Roman. He formed military alliances and avoided conflicts. After the Roman incident, okay. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the period in the Masjid Nabawi won war between Rome and also the Persia. The Roman people are the followers of Christianity, and the Persian people, they worship the fire. They are Majusis. They worship the fire. So they are the followers of the Vedas, the Kitab, Arabic Kitab. They are the Christian people. So for the fighting, the Majusi people, those who are the worshiping the fire, they got the victory. They, the battle in Iran, there are battles in the Iran, but the people celebrating in Makkah, the Majusi got the victory. Why? What's the reason? The Kitab peoples are defeated. The Kitab also defeated. The Muhammadis also go to defeat after some time. So that's why they're celebrating in the Makkah, the seats of Makkah. So what they think, definitely Muhammad and his Kitab and his Quran will be defeated very soon. So that's why they're celebrating this incident in the Makkah and Medina. So the Sahabas, the Kabir school, Prophet Rasulullah, they celebrate like this, dating like this. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, wait. After the Roman Empire got the victory, the Surah Rum will come. Surah Rum came. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the Sahaba, all the companions came to Masjid Nabawi for the Fajr prayer. They came for the Masjid Nabawi for the Fajr prayer. They think Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam read the Surah Rum full. The Surah Rum full. Full ayats. Full verses. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam read some of the verses, not read more. They think the Medina people, they think Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam definitely he read full surah in the Fajr prayer. But Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never read full surah. They read some ayats. So the second rakat, he read very small surah. Within 4 or 5 minutes he finished the prayer. Then after the prayer, the Fajr prayer, the companion asked the Prophet Rasulullah, why you finish this prayer very short? Usually you did the Fajr prayer very long. Usually you leave the Fajr prayer very long. Why you short it? Make it short. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam replied to the companions, you see, one of the child is crying. One of the child is crying there. It will affect my prayer. How the mother of the child will feel it. So that's why I shortened the prayer very quickly. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the mercy to the child also. He formed military alliances and avoid conflicts. Leadership principles followed by the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. As Aisha, Aliyullah Ta'ala, narrated that whenever the Prophet had to choose between two options, he always opted for the easier choice. He stuck for easier one. But for the world, for the children, the teacher, for the student, the children teach, the teacher teach from smaller one to higher one. For you also, we write alphabets in the small letter, not a capital letter. Okay? So, each and everything, if you use with a small, then first we give the small food to the child, then take the higher food, rich food. So, each and every action, we start from small things. So, the Aisha narrated, whenever the Prophet had to choose between two options, he always acted for the easier choice. The second principle, to see advantage in disadvantage. The Prophet ﷺ guided by the Quran, saw opportunities in every problem. To change the place of action, he migrated to find more suitable place to fulfill his vision, that was to deliver the message of Islam. He migrated to Medina. In the Masjid Quba is the first Jummah prayer, he gave the lecture with peace. The historians, they really told, I never see just like a Prophet Muhammad like this. Why? Even in the Masjid Quba, in the Makkah, Prophet Muhammad facing a number of problems. The people do the more torture to Prophet Muhammad in his belongings, in his lives, and also in his children. They give the more torture to Prophet Muhammad. The Prophet Muhammad, in his first sermon in the Masjid Quba, he never mentioned about the enemies. They do just like this torture. Fourth principle, to make a friend out of an enemy. The life of the Prophet is a historic testimony of this. He returned bad things by doing good, and that had a conquering effect over his enemies. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also teach to the companions, don't drink, it's not good for you, it's affected your cerebellum, and also to cry. The cerebellum is the coordinates of memory power, and also it definitely affects your body system and the skeletal system. So, one day in the Maghrib prayer, after the feast, one of the Sahaba, in the first rakat in the Maghrib prayer, Ya ayyuhal kafirun la a'budu ma ta'budun wa la antum a'buduna ma a'bud. He read like this, Ya ayyuhal kafirun la a'budu ma ta'budun wa antum a'buduna ma a'bud. Like this. So that's why the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave Basin and Hazrat Umar asked to Allah, Ya Allah, you give one ayat about the drunkard, and also the alcohol, and also the this kind of things. Ya Allah, must send one ayat, read one ayat about the clearance of the about this liqwa. So then Allah Jalla Shalu wa Ta'ala send one ayat, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, innamal khamru والميسر والأنساب والأزلام رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوه لعلكم تفلحون. Only بس ده إنما الخمر ده definitely the liquor and والميسر gambling or all the things of شيطان or the deeds of action of شيطان. You must away from these things. Definitely you will be rewarded and also got a victory in your life. And nine, that to bring the battle is one favorable field. Gradually, instead of radicalism, then to be pragmatic in controversial matters. Now we have covered key points. Our next objective is to help you glimpses of the noble messenger of Allah and benefit through his and exemplary life, and the poor formula that we provide you peace, success, and salvation. Savior and Liberator, Prophet as a Savior and Liberator. Times before the arrival of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the true concept of God was lost. The ignorance and darkness were turned to knowledge and light. The barbarism and recklessness is changed to kindness and mercy. Sexual slavery and nudity and persecution of women is changed to women's status and rights. Usury and exploitation is changed to justice and fairness. Fear and terror is changed to peace and security. Class and color discrimination, racism is changed to love and brotherhood. Let us look around. Why today the God and religion have been forgotten? Idol and human worship widely spread. Wars, conflict, and killing became day-to-day life. Terror and fear everywhere. Injustice, oppression, and no human rights at all. Marginalization of poor and have-nots, addiction, nudity and obscenity have become very common. Confusion and restlessness throughout the world. Let us have a quick introduction about our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Born at Mecca, he was a homesteader. He first married at the age of 25 to Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. The peasant appearance of Prophet Muhammad, handsome features, bright face like a temperament, graceful, handsome, eyes black and large, hair long and thick, voice clear. He's a charming, he's a beautiful to look at and well built. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, read in the name of your Lord who created, يَقْرَوْ بِسْمِ رَبِّكَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ عَلَقٍ, created man from clots of blood. اِقْرَوْ رَبُّكَ الْأَكْرَمُ, read your Lord's in the most bounteous. الَّذِي عَلَّمَ بِالْقَلَمُ, was taught the use of the pen. عَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانَ مَا لَمْ يَعْلَمُ, has taught man what he did not know. Short-term. permanent guidelines and solution, not temporary. And it addressing all human beings, rich and poor, black and white, educated and the ignorant. Addressing all aspects of life. It is for the entire world, not a region or country. It has guidance from the Creator who knows man unlike other. The best values of life we see today were given 1400 years ago. Total change happened after the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The companion Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the court of a Christian king in Abyssinia, Your Majesty, beware ignorant people, worshipping idols, eating carrion, oppressing neighbors, brother fighting brother, the strong dominating the weak. When admits as was the right man, whose nobility, integrity, and trustworthiness were already well known. He called us to worship God alone. He commanded us to speak the truth, to honor our promises, to be kind to our relations, to be helpful to our neighbors, to cease all forbidden acts, to abstain from bloodshed, to avoid obscenities and falsehoods. Preach and practice. He practiced, then he preached. If he preached, definitely he practiced. He was without a bodyguard, without a palace, without a fixed revenue. If ever any man had the right to say that he ruled by the right divine, it was Muhammad, for he had all the power without instruments, and without its support, he cared not for the losing of power. The simplicity of his private life was in keeping with his public life. Noble character. He was simple yet with elegant habits. He did not have material temptations. He relies testifies, enjoy the beauty of flowers, the fragrance of perfumes. He never scolded his young servant. When he seated among his followers, he would not have his special seat. So I am the big man, I am the prophet, he must put your special seat. No. The companions told to him, Ya Rasulullah, you are the prophet. So if any guest, if his gentleman come to us, how can he find out who is the prophet? That's why the companions put the special seat to Prophet Muhammad. Personal belongings at the time of his death, mattress of dried palm leaves, water skin, and elm. The Professor K.S. Ramakrishna Rao, in his book, Muhammad the Prophet, mentioned that the circumstances changed. The Prophet of God be done. In victory or in defeat, in power or in adversity, in affluence or in indigence, he is the same man, restores the same character. If he is the victory, if you got victory, he never brought. That's why the Quran says, إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا. Oh, Prophet Muhammad, if you got your victory, don't be proud. Your number of people, they came to observe Islam. They came to embrace Islam. So don't be proud. So then فسبح, you must do tasbih. We must seek forgiveness to Allah. So from that day, Prophet every night he made dua and he read 80 times Astaghfirullah al-Azim in his life. So that's why personal belongings at the time of his death, the mattress of dry palm and the leaves, water skin and an armor, but he never be a problem when he got the victory. That's why the Professor K.S. Rao mention about the Muhammad, the Prophet. He was the very generous, humble, and a great peacemaker. He forgave the peoples of the town of Taif who wounded him and chased him out of the city. You know that in Surah Al-Taif. He ordered kindly treatment of captives. Despite these were the very men who had inflicted insults and injuries to him. Even they speak to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam face also, he never cared about this. Sometimes, one time, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did a prayer in the Masjid Haram and the Kaaba. Abu Jahl came and also he beat with his arrow. So at the time Hazrat Hamza is in the Arkam, Dal Arkam. He prayed that place. One of the lady went to Hazrat Hamza. Oh Hamza, you are praying here. You are in the hunting. Do you know what you think in what happened in Kaaba? You know what happened in the Kaaba? Abu Jahl, he beat your son, Muhammad.